it's all right.
What is popping, guys? Randomly uploading must feel annoying. Like, dang, you don't know when I'm going to post. But some people say, you know, as long as you post this, whatever.
I don't know, man. Recently, it's been getting real busy at the shop. I got, like, sick. Like, real sick. Couldn't do anything. And I missed you guys. I had to post another video. Just trying to balance my health, the progress at the shop, and all these other things. Like, if you really listen to me, sometimes I don't even want to upload a video because you can hear my breathing OD. Like, I don't know if you can, like, really hear it right now, but it's like my passageway is restricted due to the autoimmunity. So now I'm just trying to, like, see what's pushing myself too far, trying to find certain limits and stuff like that. I still want to upload. I still want to do all these things. But, like, moving and walking with the camera has turned into a chore. Like, but nonetheless, I decided I was gonna come today and just talk to y'all real quick. Just drop a little video and just, like, give a little nugget of information or just share what's on my mind today. Oh, you hear that? Like, that breathing, like, it's crazy. What's crazy about this illness, though, is, like, many of you guys don't know because I don't really push it like that because, you know, I'm more about action. But, like, I used to be a really, what I would consider a prolific athlete, really cared about my body. The fastest I ran a mile was 4:47. I thought I jumped pretty high. Hold on, listen to my mom. Yeah, what's up? Bumba Rasta Cry. All right. Bye. I said this to myself. So apparently that was my mom, and my grandma is at the doctor. There seems to be a theme here. She just be at the doctor on here. But like I said, I'm sick. So between work, editing, I'm at hospitals. Like, I was in the ER on what, Wednesday? You're on Wednesday. Stayed overnight because I got sick. These are a bunch of things. Like, I be questioning whether I want to just share this with you because I don't want to, like, get y'all down or whatever. Oh, I don't want, like, a pity party, because to me, I just want to produce. I want to just put stuff out and handle things as they go. Well, why was I saying that? Because I was at the ENT for one of my multiple doctor visits, and my grandma called, and she was at another doctor. My mom had something to do, so we couldn't pick her up. That was like 12 something. Now it's 3:26 and she's still there. I'm just waiting on the information to go and pick her up, because now she's been out there for 4 hours, and that's crazy.
If it's all right, oh, yeah. I wanna kick it with you all night, ooh. Have a good time, ain't gotta worry, cause it's all right, all night, all night, all night, baby, don't be shy, don't be shy, don't be shy, baby, all night and all night, ain't gotta worry, cause it's
so,
all right.
Here at the spot, waiting for my grandma. Homegirl was here she's been here for like 4 hours, just chilling. Her phone was dead, she ain't really called nobody, she's just chilling up there, tired. Grandma, what's wrong with you, man?
Why did you stop?
Who said that?
Your mother, bitch.
I can't believe you were just sitting there for 4 hours.
4 hours.
Doing what?
Nothing.
I can't see
just
anything
there.
Over there.
You got what? Where? Watch them, Roma. Alright.
So what were you doing for 4 hours?
Just sitting there. What else could I do? What else could I do, my son? I just sat there.
If it's alright.
But
Post this whole video is just to reconnect and let you guys know what was going on. Last time I posted a video was 3 weeks ago. Still improving and trying to just find a balance. Like, one thing is this. I was really battling, like I said before, like if I was going to let you guys know with all the things that's been going on. I still haven't given much detail. It's just like, to me, there's a fine line between informing and excuses. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to give off the vibe or the idea that I'm just making excuses, but the alternative is just to drop whenever. You know what I'm saying? That's what I've been doing. I've kind of just been dropping whenever and then not really giving explanations when I'm not here. So, as you guys know, I started part-time at Fresh Cut in September. Then I went full-time in December, and the idea was just to allow you guys to come on the journey. I'm still doing that. It's still happening. But through it all, I'm trying to still create content. And, you know, people keep talking about my voice and how I should do a podcast. That's also something I'm thinking about. I really want to make a lot of videos. I love making videos. I love music. I love the cinematic. I love cinematic views and cinematic views. I love cinematic images and different angles, interesting music, and taking you guys on a journey in a cool way. But that is really taxing. Like, really taxing. If I can do it every day, every single day, I would. But I gotta be honest with myself. I'm trying to be honest with myself. Every time I do this, I just go on a rampage. I go for like 2 weeks, then I'm done for like a month. And I go like 2 weeks, done for like a month. I gotta find like a nice groove where I can just do it for a long time. I'm not sure how Casey Neistat does it, but I'm gonna find the secret elixir. I'm gonna find the secret. Just know I'm not giving up. And I thank you guys for staying here and supporting me. I don't think I've been very clear on what this whole thing is, like what I do on YouTube, like what my whole vision is. You guys don't really know what the vision, I just drop videos. So what I think I'm lacking, what my weakness is just clarity. I'm trying to be more clear on here, show you guys more things. Like, I remember back when I was in high school, I used to watch a bunch of YouTubers like Vic the Barber, Chuka the Barber, Ricardo the Barber, a bunch of other people on YouTube. I thought it was so cool that I was learning all this stuff just from YouTube videos. But they were just tutorials and haircuts and, you know, gear and stuff. I mean, I still want to do that. I still want to incorporate that. But what was a question to me, what was still like a big question mark, was like how it is being a barber. You know what I'm saying? Like how it is going through the process, getting your license, and then actually getting there. Like, can you live off of it? Can you make enough money? I had a bunch of questions, and that's why I'm really motivated to continue doing this, because I see the questions you guys have and I really want to answer those things, fill that gap. And I also think, like, in this industry, right, there's a lot of people in here because they lack confidence, not because they have it. You know what I mean? It's a little weird. Like, they're in here because they can't do school, quote unquote. They're in here because they didn't want to go to college, and they're not book people, and all these different, like, it's like they're in it because they don't have options, not because they believe they do. I came in here, I went to college, not because I care about college, not because I care about a degree. I actually don't. I got my degree because my parents wanted me to get it, and I was like, look, I can do this, and I can do this. So once I got my psych degree, I gave my degree to my mom and told her, look, I'm gonna make a life over here, because look, in today's day and age, the people who win are the ones who understand the market and the ones who see the need and then they provide it. I saw a post on a couple days ago. I saw a post on Barber's World. It's a Facebook group on Facebook. Oh, by the way, I'm gonna be on a podcast with I Do It Barber. I Do It One Word, I believe. It's gonna be at 9:30 on Wednesday. So check that out. I'm gonna remind you guys on Instagram, but yeah, it's gonna be dope. So check that joint out. Yeah, but I saw a post on Facebook, you're not a boss until you own your own shop or something like that. And I just felt like that was such a shallow thought. Like, it's just so surface, like he didn't really think about it. I said, owning a shop doesn't mean you're doing what you want. Like, looking at a lot of these people, some shop owners are actually not doing what they want. Some shop owners are doing it because they think people think they're bosses. You see how that works? You know what I'm saying? Like, some people aren't slave to, in this free nation, most people are slave to concepts than anything else. Slave to ideas, you know, like you're racing. Because to me, I was pretty much slave to that thought. Like, I thought, like, yo, the goal is to own a shop. Like, one day I'm going to own a shop. I'm going to own my own thing. No, the goal is to live every day the way you want to live it. If you're going to be going to a shop, cutting hair, then you go home, you see your girl, like, you see family. You just get to live your day the way you want to live it. If you want to go home and read a newspaper, whatever, ultimately, you got to sit down and think of the life you want to live. And if you're living it, or are there, like, stipulations or limitations where you feel you aren't living the life you want to live? Owning a shop equaling being a boss is somebody else's idea. That's not a fact. That's not, just because you own a shop, it doesn't mean you're a boss. And just because you work alone, doesn't mean you're better than somebody who works with somebody. People say under, or people say employee. At the end of the day, I don't even know anymore. Because when it comes to a barber and a shop owner, I consider those two partners. You give me a space. We work together to serve the community. I'm cutting hair, just gotta come in and do me, and then I leave. Like, is that what I wanna do? If I'm doing that, then I'm a boss. That's what I wanna do. You're not a boss, you're a slave if you're doing things based on other people's ideas or doing things that you don't wanna do. You're slave to a concept. Make sure you check yourself. That's why it's all about self-awareness. It's about self-awareness, because a lot of people can be living a life that they're not sure they're living, or living somebody else's life, and they're not aware that they're doing it. Overall, I was in my basement, right? I had the idea, again, slave to an idea. I thought I was gonna be a boss, you know, build up from my house, go straight from my house to a shop, and then, you know, everybody's gonna love the barber's table and all these different things. I know my goal was to, when I wanted to learn the industry, I'm not in this just to be in it. You know, I can cut hair today and not the next day, because to me, it's bigger than hair. To me, it's bigger than cutting. I'm not just a barber. I consider myself like a thought leader, somebody who wants to change the industry and change the way people think and help provide perspectives. And I see clippers as a vehicle. I see a camera as a vehicle to do that. So it's like I'm going somewhere. I'm not staying in the same place. You understand what I'm saying? So I ended up leaving because I started feeling uncomfortable online and just overall just advertising my house, for one. I wasn't quite comfortable with that, especially since this is my parents' house and I don't plan on staying here. So it's like, well, I do all that advertising for a space, for an area I won't be in for the long term, for the long run, you know what I'm saying? It didn't really make sense in my mind. On top of that, it's just not a good location. Nobody's gonna pass by my house and say, hey, that's the barber's table, let's just roll up in there. And it wasn't comfortable or conducive to new clients. You know, I think when you're in a shop alone in your house, you should probably already be booked, not be building, because you want everybody that's coming into your house to know you, to know, like, the situation, to really it be really clear and, you know, set, not really, hey, my name's Kevin, like, hi, like, this is my house, like, you know, like, that's a little weird, like, this is my house, upstairs is my kitchen, and above that is my bedroom, like, you want to really know people. And I didn't feel like I was servicing the community. I wasn't really getting to know people, know businesses, like, I feel like a little more connected to the area being in the shop that I'm in now. And I also just wanted to learn the business. Like, I couldn't really learn the business by myself in here. You know, I'm just doing the same thing I did in college, learning people, which is great. I think barbers are probably one of the best marketers ever because they have the one-on-one connection with people on the daily. And it's funny, the same exact thing happened in college. So it's like a reoccurring lesson, which is why I like paying attention to myself. I have this inclination to be alone because I like working alone. YouTube, all these things, I like working alone. That's just my thing. I like controlling my stuff, which is why it was important for me to be in a shop where I could feel like I had that same creative license, you know? But anyway, I was in college and I was cutting hair in my room when there were barbers cutting hair in a stairwell. You know what I'm saying? To me, it was a little, I didn't want to go in the stairwell. Like, I just wanted to cut in my room, but the community understood the stairwell to be a place where people cut hair. And I didn't have a clientele to just stay in my room. I didn't really have anybody, just one or two, three people I knew before I went to college. So then I came to the stairwell, and as the years gone on, that was one of the best decisions I made because I grew faster and more people saw me. From now, my senior year, I probably could have went back in my room. It wasn't like I was paying rent or anything, so it wouldn't have been necessary. But it was nice to, one, have a place where I cut and went back to my room instead of being in my room and cut and it get messed up and I clean it. And it was, all that's beside the point. But it's just interesting to see that I've seen this before, and I'm learning my lesson and paying attention to what happened in the past. I mean, but this is my first time getting to a shop. I haven't told you guys this before, but this Fresh Cut is like the fourth shop I tried. I'll get into that story later. Yeah, I learned I needed to get out of the house, and that's basically what it was. And hope you guys liked today's episode. It was a really long-winded, but see you guys in the next episode. Thanks for listening. Kev the Barber, the Barber's Table, out of here.